Whiskey 2, U.S. Radio.
Whiskey 2, U.S. Radio, go.
Yeah, thanks, Jim. I need you to work your magic again, my friend. I really appreciate the work in the past, and I'm running a Bluetooth headset off of an article in CQ magazine, how to use a Plantronics home desk telephone headset for HF, and I've got it on now, and we can take a look, and I'm looking for any suggestions. The name here is Bill, Bravo India Lima Lima, running 400 watts, 350, from Silver Springs, Florida. Over.
Roger, Bill. Well, it sounds good, and it looks pretty good. Give me a little bit more audio, and let me see what your range is and all that. Tell me about your what you found interesting about the wireless mic.
Yeah, fine business. Well, the article was in CQ magazine, and being in a motorhome, this gives me the ability to walk outside, copy the mail, use Vox, and still do HF. And the range on it is up to 350 feet. And the audio reports, I've tried to match what you've done for me on the hand mic, listening to the monitor, so I hope I'm close. I'm using an FT891, and I'm running my audio gain about mid-ACL, for your recommendation, at a number of 22 out of 100. I've got 10 on the compression out of 100, and my EQ, parametric equalizer, has three stages similar to the FTDX 1200 and 3000. Over.
Roger. Well, it looks good. It sounds good. I would run it like that. Thing is, obviously, when you're working that close to a boom, there is a possibility of getting some audio transients in there. But if you had, you're not showing much of that now, but if you did develop some later on, it might be that you could run some a little extra foam on that boom mic, from cut from another foam windscreen, Roger.
Well, I'm a student of your channel, and I just put on the homemade foam over the top of the mic in anticipation of your suggestion, and I'm wondering if you notice a difference.
I didn't notice that time. You know, there is a difference between the side of that foam windscreen and the front of the foam windscreen. About the front is usually about two layers thick, whereas the side is about one layer thick. Roger.
Roger. And I've got a thick one on now. I did make a thinner one as well. If this is not changing the audio much, I suspect the thicker would probably do better for blow-by and sounds that may come out of the headset.
Roger. Now, you might try pulling off mic, just putting the mic out in front of you just a little bit more than, give yourself just a little breathing room between your mouth and the mic. Roger.
Roger. In this particular case, it's hard to bend it out. It's not that flexible, but I did drop it down a touch so that I'd be breathing straight out, not past it, and certainly, hopefully this sounds okay.
Oh, I think that's the answer right there. I would run it just like that, Roger.
Thanks so much. I know you're running close to five, and there's other stations that want to come in. I appreciate all the education I've gotten on audio, and it looks like it's been put to good use. Hi. So I'll lock everything down where it is, say thanks so much, and really appreciate it. KC9VKV, Whiskey 2, U.S. Radio, Silver Springs, will be clear listening out.
Roger. Three is that away, sir. Sounding good. And if you can, check in next Friday, and we'll compare notes and see where we are. So three is for now, though, and you have a good afternoon and a good evening. This is Kilo Charlie 9, Victor Kilo Victor, and the Friday afternoon QSO Vlog program. If you have a radio, you want to check the audio on, give us a call. We are recording. This is KC9 VKV.